Hello everyone. Today we are starting a new chapter, Some Applications of Trigonometry. And in this chapter we will study that how we will apply trigonometry in our daily life situations. That is, if you know or if you want to know height and distances of certain objects, how we can use trigonometry without measuring them actually. For that, you have first topic as heights and distances, and you should know two things in order to apply trigonometry. That is, one is angle of elevation and the other one is angle of depression. Now first we will see that what is angle of elevation. So you can see a figure. In this point O is the eye of the observer. That is, if I am like this, this is the eye of the observer, means from here I am taking a horizontal line. So OX is the horizontal line from this eye. And if I am just looking upward to see an object, so this is the object. So I am just looking like this to see the object, means this is the line of sight. That means through which line I am seeing the object, that is the line of sight. And the angle made by this horizontal and between the horizontal line and the line of sight is called the angle of elevation. That means when I look up to see an object, the angle formed is known as the angle of elevation. Now for angle of depression, this is the eye of the observer. So OX will be the horizontal line like this again. Now if the person is looking down to see the object like this, then the angle made between the horizontal line and the line of sight, so this will be your line of sight. So angle made between the horizontal line and the line of sight will be the angle of depression. So this is the object, we are just looking down. So this is the horizontal line from the eye and we are looking down, means in between the angle formed is known as the angle of depression. Are both clear? So now we are starting the exercise 9.1. Question number 1 is, a circus artist is climbing a 20 meter long rope which is tightly stretched and tied from the top of a vertical pole to the ground. Find the height of the pole if the angle made by the rope with the ground level is 30 degree. So the figure is given in the question. Even if it is not given, you have to draw the figure by yourself from the concept given in the question. So you have to get a rope, then a vertical pole and the ground, and they are saying that the vertical pole is, the top of the vertical pole has been tied with a rope to the ground, and the length of the rope is given to be 20 meter, and the angle between the rope, or the rope is forming an angle with the ground of angle of 30 degree. So what we have to find out, we have to get this height of the pole. So that we are taking a variable h, okay. Now what we have to do is, we have to choose that trigonometric ratio which will include the unknown thing which has to be found out and the known fact which is given in the question. That means if I see this angle, this angle's opposite side is this one, that is the thing which we need. Suppose this is height h, so h we have to find out. So what we will see, h is this opposite side and this is your hypotenuse. So what you will get is, you have to include opposite side by hypotenuse in order to get this one, right? Now what is opposite side by hypotenuse? It is sine of the angle. So we have to consider from this right triangle what is sine 30 degree, and from that you can find out what is the height of the pole, okay? So let h be the height of the pole. Now consider triangle ABC, which is right angled at B. All the trigonometric ratios are based on right triangle only. That's why we have done that horizontal line and the angle of elevation or depression. So that horizontal and the angle will give you a right triangle. Okay. So here we are considering this triangle which is right angled at B. And here what we are considering, we are taking sine 30 degree. Sine 30 degree, which is opposite side, that is AB by hypotenuse AC. Now what is AB? We have taken it as H. H be the height of the pole. And AC is given to be 20. Now what is sine 30 degree? It is 1 by 2. So from this you can find out what is H equal to. What is H? It is 20 by 2, which is equal to 10, right? 10 meters. So you can say that therefore the height of the pole is 10 meters. Okay. Question number 2 is, a tree breaks due to storm and the broken part bends so that the top of the tree touches the ground, making an angle 30 degree with it. The distance between the foot of the tree to the point where the top touches the ground is 8 meter. Find the height of the tree. So a rough figure on the side, you can just see. I've taken AC as the total height of the tree. Now this tree has been broken from this point, suppose, so that this length will be same as this length. That means AB will be same as BD. And it is touching the ground at a distance from the foot of the tree where it is touching. That distance is given to be 8 meter. Okay. And you have to find out the total height of the tree. That means first we will consider this triangle and find out what is this length, and then we will move to this length. Now this length, that is BD, will be same as this part which has been broken down, right? So here I am just writing this will be also Y. So our purpose is to find both X and Y, and then the height of the tree will be X plus Y. This I have taken X, this much length I have taken Y, and so it is X plus Y which you need to find out here. Okay, so let AB is equal to Y meters and BC is equal to X meters. Okay, that we have taken, and our purpose is to find out AC, that is X plus Y. Now we will consider triangle BCD. Again, it is right angled at C. So from triangle BCD, again we have to plan which we have to take, that means which trigonometric ratio we have to consider. Now suppose both are unknowns, means we have to include one known and one unknown. So if I am planning to find out X, I have to include X, means this height BC, I have to include what? Opposite side by adjacent side, which is, we are knowing this value, that's why we are including this adjacent side. What is opposite side by adjacent side? That is your tan of that angle, right? So we are considering tan of that angle. What is that angle? 30 degree. So tan 30 degree is equal to BC by DC. Now what is BC? X. And what is DC? 8. And what is tan 30 degree? It is 1 by root 3. So 1 by root 3 is equal to X by 8, which will give you X is equal to 8 by root 3. So X, let it be here. Now our purpose is to find out what is Y. Again, this length is Y, but this will be same as this one. So what we need to find out now, this is, suppose if you are taking opposite side by hypotenuse, then also, because now your X is also known. So X by Y also you can use, or you can use adjacent side by hypotenuse. That is, either you can use sine of the angle or you can use cos of the angle. Now if suppose I am using sine of the angle, what will be sine 30 degree? It will be opposite side by hypotenuse. That means X by Y. Or what is sine 30 degree? Sine 30 degree is 1 by 2 is equal to X by Y, which implies what you need to find out Y. Y is equal to 2X. And what is X equal to? It is 8 by root 3 meters. So you'll get 2 into 8 by root 3, which is equal to 16 by root 3 meters. This is Y. Now our main purpose is to find out the height of the tree. Therefore, the height of the tree is equal to AC, which is same as X plus Y, is equal to 8 by root 3 plus 16 by root 3. Now taking root 3 in common, you will get it is 24 by root 3. And we are again removing the irrational number in the denominator, taking root 3 in the numerator and denominator and multiplying. So we'll get 24 by root 3 into root 3 by root 3, which will give you, this will become root 3 into root 3, which is 3. So it is 24 root 3 by 3, which will give you 8 root 3 meters as answer. That is 8 root 3 meters is the height of the tree. Okay. Question number 3 is, a contractor plans to install 2 slides for the children to play in a park. For the children below the age of 5 years, she prefers to have a slide whose top is at a height of 1.5 meter and is inclined at an angle of 30 degree to the ground. That is, first figure is based on the slide for the children below the age of 5 years. So its height, that is, it is at a height of 1.5 meter and it is inclined with the ground at an angle of 30 degree. Okay. Whereas for elder children, she wants to have a steep slide at a height of 3 meter and inclined at an angle of 60 degree to the ground. So this is the second slide for the elder children and it should be more steeper than the first slide. That is her intention, and the height of the, that is, she wants to have the steep slide at a height of 3 meters. So this is the total height from where the slide is starting and at from to the ground it is making an angle of 60 degree. That is, the slide is making an angle of 60 degree with the ground. And you have to find out the length of the slide used in both the cases. So first case, I have taken a triangle, right angle at A, triangle ABC, and this is AC is 1.5 meter and let this, that is BC, which you have to find out the length of the slide, be taken as X meters and the angle made is, that is CAB is equal to 30 degree. And we have to think that using which trigonometric ratio will we get this value, or we have to include this and the known thing. So if this is the angle, it's opposite side and hypotenuse you have to include. That means opposite side by hypotenuse is your sine ratio, right? Sine is the trigonometric ratio which you have to use. So sine 30 will give you the value of X. And for the second figure also, you have, this is known, angle is known, and you have to include this in order to find the value. So opposite side by hypotenuse again in this case will give you sine angle. Sine 60 degree will give you the length of the second slide also. Okay, so let BC is equal to X meters and EF is equal to Y meters in the respective triangles. Now in triangle ABC, when you are considering, what you will get, we will take sine 30 degree, which is equal to opposite side, that is AC by hypotenuse, which is BC. What is AC? 1.5, and what is BC? X. So that sine 30 is 1 by 2 is equal to 1.5 by X, which will give you X is equal to 1.5 into 2, which is 3. So X is 3 meters. That is, the length of the first slide is 3 meters. Now we will move on to the second triangle, that is in triangle DEF. Again, we will consider sine angle, that is sine 60 degree is equal to opposite side, which is DF by FE, which is equal to 3 by Y. Now, what is sine 60 degree? It is root 3 by 2. So, root 3 by 2 is equal to 3 by Y, or Y is equal to, or you can say Y root 3 is equal to 6, and Y is equal to 6 by root 3. Now 6 by root 3 can be written as 6 root 3 by 3, or you will get 6 root 3 by 3 as 2 root 3 meters. So this is the length of the second slide. Therefore, the length of the slide for children below 5 years is 3 meters and the length of the slide for elder children is equal to 2 root 3 meters. Okay. Question number 4 is the angle of elevation of the top of a tower from a point on the ground which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower is 30 degree. Find the height of the tower. So let us take this as the height of the tower, and the angle of elevation is given means from a point on the ground we are looking upwards to the top of the tower. At that time the angle formed is known as the angle of elevation. So that is given to be 30 degree, and that point is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower. So this is the figure, and you have to find out the height of the tower. So let the height of the tower be h. meters. Okay. Now when this is h, you have to include this and the side which is given in the question. So for that, which trigonometric ratio is suitable? You just see opposite side by adjacent side. So you have to take tan of the angle given in order to get or included this side and this side, the unknown that is to be found outside and the known side. Okay. So you will consider triangle ABC. You have to find out what is tan 30 degree. Tan 30 degree is opposite side, which is AB by BC, opposite side by adjacent side. Now what is tan 30 degree? 1 by root 3, which is equal to AB you have taken as H, BC is 30. So you are getting H is equal to 30 by root 3. This will come there. So 30 by root 3. Now we will just rationalize the denominator. That means we are multiplying with root 3 in the numerator as well as denominator, so that this becomes 30 root 3 divided by root 3 into root 3 is 3. So this will give you 10 root 3 meters. What is that? H. Therefore, the height of the tower is 10 root 3 meters. Okay. Question number 5 is, a kite is flying at a height of 60 meter above the ground. The string attached to the kite is temporarily tied to a point on the ground. The inclination of the string with the ground is 60 degrees. Find the length of the string, assuming that there is no slack in the string. So if we are taking, this is the string. So you have to find out the length of the string. And this is the height at which it is, that is the kite is there. And that is given to be 60 meters, and the angle made by the string, this string is tied to the ground temporarily. The kite is temporarily tied to a point on the ground means this is the length of the string and it has been tied here. So kite is here, this is string, here it has been attached temporarily, and the inclination is given, that is this string making with the ground as 60 degrees. You have to find out this length of the string, assuming that there is no slack in the string. That means there is no twist and turns in the string. It has been just tightly stretched here so that it can be taken as a straight line. Okay. So we can consider AC as the length of the string as X meters. Okay. Let the length of the string be X meters. And considering the triangle ABC, now we have to see which trigonometric ratio will give you that side which is to be found out and the side including which is given. So if I am taking this one as angle, this is opposite side and this is hypotenuse. So you have to take opposite side by hypotenuse or hypotenuse by opposite side, so that you can either use sine or cosec. So sine is easy, so we'll take sine 60 degree is equal to. Okay, so here we are taking sine 60 degree in order to get both the sides, known and unknown. It is opposite side, which is AB by hypotenuse, which is AC. Now what is AB? It is 60 and AC is taken to be X. Sine 60 degree is root 3 by 2. So from this you are getting X is equal to, this will go there, so it will become 120, 60 into 2. Divided by root 3. So again you can just remove root 3 from the denominator by multiplying and dividing with root 3, so that this will give you 120 root 3 by 3, root 3 into root 3, 3. This will give you 40 root 3 meters. So what is that? Therefore, the length of the string is 40 root 3 meters. Okay. Question number 6 is, a 1.5 meter tall boy is standing at some distance from a 30 meter tall building. The angle of elevation from his eyes to the top of the building increases from 30 degree to 60 degree as he walks towards the building. Find the distance he walked towards the building. So this is the 1.5 meter tall boy. That is, ED is taken as the boy's height. Then here also, that is BC will also be 1.5. And what is given to be 30 meter? This 30 meter tall building. So this is the building, that is AC is 30 meter tall. That means when I see AB, it will be 30 minus 1.5, right? AB will be equal to 30 minus 1.5, which is 28.5 meter. Now, what they are saying is the boy is walking. So first, the boy's angle of elevation, that is, he is seeing the top of the building at an angle of elevation of 30 degree. So this is your 30 degree, that is from the eye. Okay. So this height is there, and from this point, the angle is given to be 30 degrees, and the child is moving towards the building till the angle becomes 60 degrees. Okay. So he, suppose this is the point where the angle of elevation becomes 60 degree. So what we have to find out is, what is that distance which the child has traveled for the elevation being 30 degree to 60 degree. That means the distance he walked towards the building. EF is to be found out. So what we will do is, we will consider two triangles here. AEB, that is A, this angle, and AFB. These two triangles will give you the values of this length and this length. And after that, from the bigger length, that is EB minus FB, will give you EF. So this is our ultimate purpose, to find out the distance traveled by the child. Okay. Now let AC be the height of the building, which is given to be 30 meters, and ED is the height of the boy, which is given to be 1.5 meter. Therefore, AB is equal to AC minus BC. Why BC? Because it is same as ED. Okay, so since ED is equal to BC, so you will get 30 minus 1.5, which is equal to 28.5 meters, which is your AB. Okay, now we are considering two triangles. That is, first triangle is in right triangle ABE. What we have to consider? We need this length AEB, means right angled only we can consider. So from first bigger triangle ABE, you will get 30 degrees elevation, right? So for that, what you have to consider is, you know this length AB, and you have to find out this length. So you have to include opposite and adjacent side. That means you have to take what is tan 30 degree. Tan 30 degrees will be AB by EB. What is AB? 28.5. What is tan 30 degree? 1 by root 3. And EB is to be found out. So this will give you, EB is equal to 28.5 root 3 meters. Okay. Now we will move on to the next triangle, that is ABF. So in triangle ABF, again, you just see, you want this length, and this length is known to you. So opposite side by adjacent side. Again, you will consider tan 60 degree, which is equal to AB by FB. What is tan 60 degree, which is root 3. AB is again 28.5 divided by FB, which you want. Okay, this will give you FB is equal to 28.5 by root 3. which is equal to 28.5 into root 3 by root 3 into root 3, which is 3. And this is giving you how much value you will get? 9.5. Okay, 9.5 root 3 meters will be FB. 9.5 root 3 meters. Now what you need is EF. Therefore, EF, which is the distance traveled by the boy, is equal to EF, and EF will be equal to EB minus FB, which is equal to 28.5 root 3 minus 9.5 root 3 equal to 19 root 3 meters. So this is the distance traveled the boy towards the building. Okay.